So for the remainder of this lesson, and then the next one, we're going to be talking about motion estimation. Basically, given a sequence, tell me what moved, tell me how it moved. Generally, you can say there are two different approaches to this. The first approach involves feature-based methods. Now, feature-based methods are just what you might think. Extract some visual features like corners, textured areas. Oh yeah, we know all about that. And track them across multiple frames. So that is, find them from one frame into another. Oh, we know all about that too. And that will give you what's called a sparse motion field. That is, you don't have the motion of all the points. You have a motion of a bunch of points that were good to track. All right, but that works really well when image motion is large, so you move like tens of pixels and you have a significant change between frames. The other method, class of methods, are what are called direct or dense methods. In dense methods, you're sort of directly recovering the motion of every pixel, of each pixel, from the fancy word is spatial temporal image brightness variation. So in other words, remember that volume, X, Y, and T? So you can think of gradients, you can think of flow within that volume. And what you're trying to do is you're trying to recover that flow based upon how the appearance changes over time. It gives you a very dense motion field, but it can be sensitive to appearance changes. This type of analysis is suitable for video, where you're getting samples very quickly, so things don't move very much in time. And in fact, if things are somewhat smooth in time and space, I could say, well, from one frame to the next, I can talk about how things are moving, like, say, a first derivative. If you're worried that a Taylor series expansion is in our future today, well, maybe tomorrow, yes. Okay, but the idea is that it's good for nice, dense, smoothly moving things.